Modern cars are full of wires, but any car with a battery in it has wires somewhere, regardless of age. Those wires are almost exclusively stranded wire rather than solid wire, even though solid wire has many superior and desirable qualities. Because the copper in a solid wire has less surface area, it's less exposed to potential corrosion from things like battery acid and whatever's in that puddle you drove through on the way home. Solid wire can also handle more current at a given diameter, since less of its cross-section would be empty pockets of air between the copper strands. With that in mind, why use stranded wire? Well, it mostly comes down to movement. There are so many points of articulation within a vehicle that wire has to travel across, and the whole frame of the vehicle will flex to some degree. Solid wire can bend, but bend it enough and it will work harden, which makes it less willing to bend in the other direction and more ready to break. So, in order to have wire flex in areas like suspension components, door hinges, and at the engine, stranded wire is used. Because each strand in the wire can move independently and bend easier, stranded wire can last a very long time in the typical automotive environment. This doesn't mean that stranded wire will last forever, but since most wires make it to the end of a vehicle's working life with no sign of having issues, typically the only things that wear out stranded wire before a car gets crushed are extreme vehicle use, bad repairs or modifications, battery acid wicking into it, and collision damage. Solid wires would also require different connectors for repairs and couldn't be soldered to with more wire like this. Solid wires are generally used in buildings since they're not going anywhere, and if they do go somewhere, the wiring is the least of your concern. So if you're working on your car and need some wire, make sure you get stranded wire. It's the only kind of wire I've seen auto parts stores sell, but since a lot of people now use Jeff's website to buy auto parts, it's good to make sure you're getting the right stuff. Make sure you put the heat shrink on before you solder your wires together, and I'll see you in the next Car Simplified video.